Dear स्टूडेंट्स, आज आप लोग मुझे आशा है कि दूरदर्शन पर होने वाले रामायण को जरूर देखे होंगे। रामायण का प्रसारण जो अभी किया जा रहा है आज के युवाओं के लिए बहुत ही प्रासंगिक है, इसलिए इसे देखते रहें। आज हम लोग स्टैंडर्ड 9 के हिस्ट्री का एक फर्स्ट चैप्टर जिसका नाम है फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन, उस पर हम लोग बातचीत करेंगे और उसके बारे में सीखने का प्रयास करेंगे। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, कॉन्सेंट्रेट योर माइंड ऑन चैप्टर फर्स्ट, दैट इज फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन। It is especially for a standard 9th student. Now, students, we have to know what we have to study in this chapter. It is very important. As it is written here, French Revolution. First of all, we have to know the meaning of revolution. Revolution means complete change. In any aspect, when we are talking about industrial revolution, that means the complete change in industrial process. When we are talking about print revolution, it means complete change in the printing process. Likewise, in France also a complete change was taken place, and that was the transformation from absolute monarchy. Monarchy means the rule of kings or queens, to democratic setup. And in the journey from absolute monarchy to democracy, French suffered under different kinds of government as well as different kinds of problems. And how was these changes taking place, we have to discuss in this chapter. First of all, we should divide this chapter into different categories. First category should be the condition in France before the French Revolution. The second category should be what happened during the French Revolution. Third category, we have to know about the changing, the reforms which were taken place in France. And fourth category, what was the legacy of the French Revolution for the world. That we have to study. Now, today we are going to discuss the conditions which were existed in France before the French Revolution. As we know, the French Revolution was taken place in 1789. So, what was the condition before 1789? France had the rule of absolute monarchy under the Bourbon dynasty, in which the rulers selected on the basis of hereditary, on the basis of dynasty. The son of the king was succeeded on the throne of their fathers. That's why it is called hereditary. So France had absolute monarchy, where all the powers were concentrated in the hands of the king. The second condition was the societies were divided into three categories. They were known as first estate, second estate, third estate. First estate comprised of clergies. They were priestly class. Priestly means pujari. Priestly classes of churches. second class is where second class is class consisted of nobles. They were advisors of the king. And third state, which consisted of common people, which included peasants, professionals, servicemen, and other people. The third condition was, in France, there was sumptuary law. What was the sumptuary law? It was a legal social law which determined the living condition of different categories of people. Categories means those who lived in first estate, those who lived in second estate, those who lived in third estate. And the king had also some privileges which were not allowed to followed by any category. That was the sumptuary law, which determined their eating materials, dressing habits, etc. And the France, which always got engaged in war affairs, and when France was succeeded by Louis XVI, who was the king under the Bourbon dynasty before French Revolution 1789, then the treasury means khajana, the treasury of France was empty. And that meantime, the king of France, Louis XVI, got married with Austrian princess Marie Antoinette, and she was luxury loving. The expenditure in the king's palace was also too much. So that time France suffered under economic crisis due to bad harvesting and low productivity in agriculture. In France there was subsistence crisis also prevailed before the French Revolution. What was the subsistence crisis? It was an extreme condition in which people were unable to fulfill even their basic necessities. And why did this crisis come into existence? This crisis came into existence due to rapid growth in population, low productivity in agriculture, and unprecedented rise in the prices of essential commodities. Apart from this, the three categories of societies were divided into two categories, privileged and non-privileged. Privileged groups were those who were in first estate or second estate, I mean to say clergies and nobles, because clergies had power even to impose taxes over the third estate. And only the non-privileged group was the third estate. The third estate people had to pay taxes only. There were provisions of two taxes. One was known as tali, another was known as tithe. Tithe was imposed by clergies, while tali was imposed by the estate. Tali was the direct tax, while tithe was the indirect tax. Tali Tariff could be changed time to time by the state, but tithi was fixed. And under tithi, the third state people had to pay 1/10 of their produce to Kalargi, and by that tax, Kalargi first met their needs, and after that, whatever their remaining, they used to give them to the king. So this condition compelled people to raise their voice before the king, and this condition led to emergence of the French Revolution. Thank you students. Aaj ke liye itna hi. Phir agle topic par hum log kal baat karenge. Is topic ko pehle padhe ki what were the condition before the French Revolution, aur isse jo jude kuch questions honge wo main kal hi dalunga aur us question ka jawab aap log likhenge. मैं आशा करता हूं कि इस वीडियो से आपको लाभ होगा और आप लोग उन प्रश्नों को अपने नोट्स कॉपी में भी बनाएंगे, उसे पॉइंट पॉइंट में आंसर को लिखेंगे और हर पॉइंट में लिखा गया आंसर आपके वार्षिक परीक्षा एनुअल एग्जामिनेशन के लिए बेनिफिशियल होगा. थैंक यू. धन्यवाद.